to his grave, and he wrote his first refrain, a testament to his pain.
Now the word got around, they said this kid is insane.
Earthquake. My garden has been trampled. Those are footprints. Who could do such a thing?
Anything that leaves a footprint that big is no who.
Do you think it was a bear?
A bear is sweet. Besides, you ever seen a bear with 40-foot feet?
A dragon?
Imaginary. Griffin? Extinct.
Giants.
Possible. Very, very possible.
Maybe we should tell someone.
Who are you going to tell?
The steward in the royal family.
The royal family? You couldn't count on that family to snuff out a rat. Oh. But the giant will all have to go to battle.
A giant has a great hard to outwit a giant.
A giant just like us, only bigger. Much, much bigger. So big that we're just an expandable bug beneath its foot. Boom! Crunch!
We are moving.
And so, the baker proceeded to the castle, but not before visiting Jack and his mother.
Look, McQuite, it's the butcher.
The baker.
The baker.
What can we do for you, son?
I'm here to investigate the structure that was left on our house today.
Jack has been home all day. The baker told Jack and his mother he feared there was a giant in the land.
I can help you. I can recognize giant footprints.
Come back over here.
Well, any help at all?
I'm sorry, sir, but you'll get none from us. Nobody came when there was a giant in my backyard. I don't remember you volunteering to come to my aid.
A giant in your backyard is one thing, but a crushed home is another.
Look, young man. Giants never strike the same house twice. I will win.
I'll take this missing castle nonetheless.
When the baker reached the castle, it was the princess who greeted his news. The story unfolds.
Excuse me, madam. This small man is just on scene.
Princess, I've come to report a giant in the land.
Where did you see this giant?
Well, I didn't exactly see it.
Then how do you know there's a giant in the land?
Because our house was destroyed in our footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. I'll go through the door.
Wait.
There was a nearby giant not so long ago descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember.
That giant was slain. Now come along.
Wait, princess, please. We have a young child. Our child is of great importance to me.
Don't worry. I'll tell the prince when he returns.
Thank you. Are we entirely through now?
Alright, Jack, I'm going off to market.
Okay, goodbye, Mother.
Now I want you to stay inside.
But I haven't been outside all day.
I don't want you going outside when there might be a giant on the loose.
But I know how to kill a giant.
Enough! Now promise me you won't leave home. Promise!
I promise.
What happened to your house?
We had a baking accident.
Frighten her.
Oh. What does Granny have to do without the bread and sweets? Besides, I have all I can carry.
Why is such a rope?
We had an accident too. I came to see a house collapse as if a big wind came and blew it in.
Oh my God.
I couldn't find my mother in the morning. So I salvaged what I could. And now I'm on.
Oh, good bird. When does that do?
What if Mother say? It's not supposed to go into the woods unescorted.
Oh, I can imagine. I'm disguised as something going to the woods. Thank you, birds.
We'll take you, Granny.
What?
We're not gonna let him go alone, are we?
All right, fine. I will take you.
No, I don't need anyone to take me to Granny's. I've gone many times before.
But you don't want to go alone when there's such a winds blowing.
Yes, that's right. We'll take you.
No.
I'm not gonna stay here when such
winds are blowing in here.
I'm taking her.
I know Mother made me promise, but I'm going to find that giant anyway.
Into the woods it's always when you think it last you through, and then into the woods you go again to take another journey.
Into the woods, the wildest there we've been before, we've not to fear. Into the woods away from here.
Into the woods to find a giant.
Into the woods to grandmother's house.
Into the woods the path is straight, no reason then to hesitate.
Into the woods it's not so late, it's just another journey.
Into the woods but not too long, the skies are strange, the winds are strong. Into the woods to see what's wrong.
Into the woods to slay a giant.
Into the woods to shield a child.
To flee the winds.
To find a future.
To shield.
To slay.
To flee,
to find,
to fix,
to hide,
to move,
to battle.
To see what the trouble is.
Kids. You don't have kids? I have two of those. You know what else I have? A husband. Do you know where he is? Probably not.
Hello.
What is he doing here?
What's the matter?
my life where I had no company. You blinded my prince. You banished me to a desert. And then I bore twins.
I was just trying to be a good mother.
Oh, and what a good mother you were.
Stay here. There's a giant running about.
No.
Hey, brother, what a surprise.
Brother, how good to see you.
Oh. What brings you into the woods today?
I'm investigating the news of a giant.
You? Investigating the news of a giant? That is the business of a steward, I guess.
And what brings you into the woods?
Well, my Rapunzel's ran off.
Ran off?
Yeah, she's a changed woman, subject to historical bits of crying moods and no soul can predict.
What
a lady. Yep. And you're Cinderella?
She means well.
Tell me, what are you doing in the woods today?
High in a tower like yours was, but higher, a beauty asleep. All round the tower, a thicket of briar, 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen. When the one thing you want is a thing you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass, though it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden, alas, just as unwakeable. What unmistakable
agony is the way always barred.
She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard.
Agony, such that princes must weep.
Always in almost to anything, almost or something asleep.
If it were not for the thicket.
The thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest.
The quickest is pick it apart with the stick.
Yes, but even one prick, it's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarves? Dwarves are very upsetting. Not forgetting the fast is unachievable. Mountains unscalable, if it's conceivable, but unavailable.
Agony, misery, not to know what you miss. While they lie there for years,
and they cry on their beds, what unbearable bliss.
Agony, that can cut like a knife.
Ah, well, back to my wife. Oh, brother, it's you. Godspeed to you.
Godspeed.
Are you certain this is the right direction?
Perhaps he forgot the way. We went down.
Well, the path was straight, and now there is no path.
Where's the stream? Where's the lily pond? Where's Granny?
Calm down. Maybe we should go back.
No!
We'll just have to go to Granny's house without the path.
But Mother said to never stray from the path.
The path has strayed from you.
Wait. That looks familiar. Three oak trees.
I recognize. Wait.
Mom,
what
Mom?
Is that noise?
Mom!
Oh, it's a steward in the royal family. What brings you here?
Cass has been set upon by a giant.
I warned you. Why did you do something?
I don't make policy. I just carry it out.
Oh.
I warned you that you can't rely on the royal family to solve your problems.
Maybe we should go back home.
I wouldn't be in such a rush if I were you to get to the giant to the castle. Home.
What?
All that was left was a sack of beans, and there's not much stuff to be house of either.
But I heard giants never strike the same house twice.
There was no consensus among us to which course of action to take.
Put a spell on her! I no longer have my powers. If I didn't think I'd be staying here with all of you people, we'd have to give her someone.
Who?
The steward. It's his line of duty to sacrifice, right?
Don't be ridiculous. I'm not giving my life up for anyone.
I'm waiting.
You must understand. These are not people familiar with making choices. Their past experiences in the woods had no way prepared to deal with a force this great.
Excuse me, but would you like a blind girl instead? Put them out of their misery.
We're not that miserable.
What are you talking about?
She doesn't want a she.
Fine, then what do you suggest we do?
I'm still waiting.
It is interesting to examine the moral issues and questions here. The finality of stories, such as these, dictates.
Yeah.
Sorry, I told the story. I'm not a part of it.
Uh-huh. That's right.
Not one of us.
You're always on the outside.
That's my role. You must understand. There must always be someone on the outside.
You're going to be on the inside now.
You're making big mistakes. Nonsense. You need an objective observer to pass the story along.
Wait. She's right. She's the only one who knows the story.
You think it'll be fun you have to tell it yourselves? Think of your baby.
She's right. Let her go.
Get her.
Put that away. What I told you about that nuts?
Now that's better. You don't want to live in the world of chaos. There must always be an outside observer.
Here's the lad!
I'm not the lad!
This is not the lad!
Wait, no, don't! Oh. Why did you push her into her arms?
You wanted to get rid of her too!
We want to follow something different!
If it was up to you, a decision would never be made. Now that she's gone, we'll never know what happens next!
We'll manage.
Must I search among you for the lad?
No!
No!
Jack is just a boy. We had no food to eat, and he sold his beloved cow in exchange for magic beads.
If anyone is to be blamed, it's the man that made that exchange.
Oh, that's right!
Nonsense!
He was your responsibility. Now I must punish him for his wrongs.
We've suffered too. Do you think it was a picnic disposing of your husband's remains?
You are getting me angry.
What about our anger? What about our loss? Who's been flouncing around our kingdom?
Shh, be quiet.
I'll hide my son and you'll never find him. You'll never, never find him.
I'm warning you.
And if you don't leave this instant, we'll get you for all you've done.
Oh, where is your son? Is that him?
No, this is not the lad. Stay here.
The boy is hiding in Steeple Tower.
Rapunzel!
If he is not, I will return and find you.
Rapunzel, my love, wait.
She's in poor condition.
Wake up! Come on,
Jack.
We won't.
Please don't let her be her.
I'll do all I can.
Promise!
Oh, I promise!
Hey, come away from there! You! You killed her!
I'll think you'll be great and good. That's my job.
Oh!
This was the world I meant. Couldn't you listen? Couldn't you stay content, safe behind walls? As I could not. No matter what you say, children won't listen. No matter what you know, children refuse to learn. Guide them along the way, still they won't listen. Children will only grow from something you love to something you lose.
We must be gone if we're to arrive before midnight.
Where are you going?
We're off to a hidden kingdom.
Shh. We can't take everyone with us.
Fools, there is nowhere to hide.
You'll never get there. We have to stick together.
Some people are proud to battle giants. Others are not. I don't have the constitution, so I can be of no help. I'm
going to
hide.
Everything
will work out this
time.
Not always.
I hope a giant steps on the wall.
You shouldn't say that.
You were thinking the same thing.
Oh. But this is terrible. We just saw 4 people die.
Since when are you so squeamish? How many wolves have you carved up?
A wolf's not the same.
Ask the wolf's mother.
suggest that we find the boy and take him to the giant.
If we take the boy to the giant, she'll kill him too.
And if we don't, she'll kill half the kingdom.
Hey, wait. One step at a time. Maybe if she apologizes, makes amends.
Yes, her return is stolen goods.
Yes.
He's a good boy at heart. She'll see that.
Wake up. You people are so blind. It's because of that boy that there's a giant in our land. But if you continue to be talking about your problems, I'll find the lad and I'll serve him to the giant for lunch.
Oh. Are we gonna let her feed the boy to the giant?
No.
I have to find him first.
I'll go too.
No, stay here with the baby.
I'm not gonna stay here. We need to go find him together.
But what if one of us gets lost?
We'll tell my steps from right here. One, two, three.
You're not coming with us.
You stay here with the baby. I do not want you to move off the woods.
Leave our child with her?
Yes, the baby will be safe with the girl.
What if the giants return here?
The child will not harm them. I know.
How do you know?
I know.
But what if?
But what if? But what if? Will only the giants flip stop your arguing? Hold your paces. Go! Wrong way!
So unpleasant, you should know that as a peasant, you should take the moment present as a present for the moment.
Let me go! Get me out of here!
Back.
Sign of the prince, no doubt he's all seducing some young maiden.
Giant. I almost forgot. What do we need to shut in the woods again?
This was just a moment in the woods. Shimmering in the inside. Take the moment, just be glad for the moment that we had. Any moment is a moment when you're in the woods. I'll never forget how brave you are and how alive you made me feel. But I gotta go.
What was that? Was that me? Was that him? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me, and kiss me. And did I kiss him back? Was it wrong? Am I mad? Is that all? Does he miss me? Was he suddenly getting bored with me? Wake up, stop dreaming, stop prancing about the woods. It's not perceiving what is it about the woods. Back to life, back to sense, back to child, back to husband, make him live in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shoulds and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever. Have a child for warmth and a baker for bread and a prince for whatever. Face the facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of these woods. Was that him? Yes, that was. Was that me? No, it wasn't, just a trick of the wood. Just a moment, one peculiar passing moment. Must it either be less or more, either plain or grand? Is it always or is it never end? That's what woods are for those moments in the wood. But if life were made of moments, even now and then a bad one. But if life were made of moments, then you never know you've had one. First a witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment who can live in the woods. And to get what you wish, only just for a moment, these are dangerous woods. How I don't wanna live in the woods. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remembering you've had an end when you're back to home. Makes the old me know that it did before. Now I understand.
Never let her wander off alone. I should have insisted that she stay at home with the baby!
Reminds me, I get to nowhere!
My wife is dead!
Wake up! People are dying all around you! You're not the only one to suffer a loss. When you're dead, you're dead. Now it's time to give this boy to the giant, we'll all be dead meat!
Leave him alone.
This is no time to be soft hearted. He's going to the giant and I'm taking him.
No!
Yes. He's the one to blame. It's because of you that's a bitch on our giant and my wife is dead.
But it isn't my fault. I was given those beans to persuade me to trade with my cow for beans. And without those beans, there would have been no stock to get up to the giant in the first place.
Wait a minute. Magic beans for a cow so old that you had a ton of fine to sell it with you told. Were they worthless beans? Were they old birds? So, oh, tell us who persuaded you to steal back. Go!
See, so it's your fault!
No, so it's your fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true. Wait a minute. The owners of the building of my cow back from you.
So it's your fault.
No, but it's not. Kept those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get a cow to get the curse reversed.
His father's fault that the curse got placed in the place that cursed in the first place.
Oh, then it's his fault.
So?
It's his fault.
No, yes it is. It's his.
I guess.
Wait a minute. Though I chopped out a beanstalk, right? That's clear. But without any beanstalk, then what's clear is how did the second giant get down here in the first place?
Yes.
But who had the other bean?
The other bean?
Pocketed the other
bean. Yes, I did.
So is your.
No, it isn't, because I gave it to my wife.
So is her.
No, it isn't.
Then whose is it?
She exchanged that bean to obtain your shoe, so the one who knows what happened to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that your wife owed dear, but I never knew it, so I don't look here.
So it's your fault.
But
see, it's her fault.
But
is it mine now?
But what?
But you hadn't gone back up again.
We were needy.
You were greedy. Did you need that head?
But I got it from my mother.
So it's her fault then. Yes, what about the heart in the third place?
The heart, yes.
She went and damaged you.
I did too.
Damaged you. She said that I was cursed, so she did.
No, I didn't.
So it's her fault.
Wait a minute.
It was you who raised him in the first place. You're responsible. You're the one to blame. It's your fault.
Thank you.
Perhaps you shouldn't have.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
But you said we had to find a way out of this together.
Whether we're together or not, it doesn't matter now.
But we need your help.
You don't understand. My wife was the one who really helped. I depended on her for everything.
What about your son?
My child would be happier in the arms of a princess. I thought you were dead.
Not completely. Are we ever?
As far as I'm concerned, you are.
Is that true?
You all of this has happened!
I strayed into the garden to get your mother a gift. And Dalton took some of the beans for myself. But how was I to know? How are we ever to know? And when she died, I ran away from my guilt. But aren't you doing the same?
No.
Aren't you making the same mistake?
I knew you would turn.
He wasn't going to leave his child.
Looked like he was going to.
What are we to do now?
He always cries when I hold him.
We have to think soon.
We have to think.
She's too tall to surprise.
Oh, good birds. I need your help more than ever. Huh? What about the birds? I don't care. What important now is to find a way to kill the giants. Look at that. How can I ever repay you?
You can talk to birds?
The birds will help.
How?
When the birds come, and the giant is there, the birds will attack her and take out her eyes until she's blind.
What good will that do?
Well, she won't be able to see, and we could hit her and do whatever it takes to kill her.
She'll just get angry and stab her about.
And she'll crush us.
Smear the ground with pitch.
What?
We'll lure her to an area smeared with pitch.
Then she won't be able to move because her shoes are stuck.
I finally get to kill another giant!
I'm excited.
We'll all have to go before it's midnight.
Get some pitch and friends.
Oh, baby. The baby will be safe here with you.
No, no, little one. I know you want your mother.
Oh, there.
The town in that direction.
Okay, oh!
Honey, so what are you doing with those old clothes and with the child? Come on, so castle right now.
The child has already been at the castle.
Why are you so close? And what's wrong with you? You all right?
Maybe because I'm not your only love, now I'm
right. I love you, I do. But yes, this is true.
If you love me, you would have strayed.
But when I'm around you, I just feel so peaceful and comfortable. But there's just like a part of me that just wants to search out there. And I just need more. I just can't. It's like an addiction. I'm sorry.
I too admit that I want more, but that doesn't mean that I go search for more. If this had to be a prince, how would you ever be able to king?
Okay, first of all, I was raised to be charming, not sincere. Second of all, I didn't ask to be born into this world, but I was born into it anyway, so it's not my fault. And third of all, I want what I want, and there's no stopping me from getting what I want. But I don't. Well, Dan, if this is what you wish, this is really what you wish for.
My father's house is a nightmare. Yours was a dream. Now I want something in its way. Please go.
Well, I'll always love the maiden that ran away.
They're almost finished. When your giant comes, you just send her over there between those two, please.
Somebody, a giant was in
giants and humans. Aren't we to show forgiveness? Mother would be very unhappy with this.
Mother, I'm very true.
Struck a deadly blow by the prince's
sword. Why would he do such a thing?
He was afraid she was provoking the giant.
Then I shall kill him.
No, you will do nothing of the kind.
But what he did was wrong, right?
But he will pay for it somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I can't answer.
Then fine. I shall slay him myself.
Then kill him. And I don't kill him. Wrong things, right things. Who can say what's true? Two things, fight things. You decide, but you are not alone. No one is alone, believe me.
Truly.
You move just a finger. Say the slightest word. Some things bound to linger, be heard. No one that's alone, careful, no one is alone. People make mistakes, fathers,
mothers.
People make mistakes, holding to their wrong, thinking they're alone. Fight for their mistakes.
Everybody makes
one another's terrible mistakes. Wishes can be right. Giants can be good. You decide what's right. You decide what's good.
Just remember,
someone is on your side. Someone else is not. While we're seeing our side, maybe we forgot. They are not alone. No one is alone. Just don't let it go. Things will turn out right now. We can make it so. Someone.
Here they come!
Where's the boy?
We don't know.
Yes, we do. He has to pay for his wrongdoing.
Quick, tell me where he is.
You see that tree where all the birds are clustered? That's where he's hiding.
Thank you. My justice will be served, and I shall be your kingdom.
Good birds.
Help!
She's falling all over!
He's falling!
Run!
She's falling this way!
The greater the good, the harder the blow.
when going to hide, know how to get there and how to get back.
And eat first.
A knife that is sharp today may be dull by tomorrow.
Now we can return home and hope there'll be no more killings.
But where am I to go? I have no home.
You'll have to take care of yourself now, Jack. It's time.
No, I'll be his mother now.
I don't want another mother. I want a friend and a pet.
Of course. And we'll need a place to stay.
My house is a shambles and of course. You'll not return to the castle?
There's sometimes I do like thinking.
How proud my wife would have been of us, and how sad my son will never know her. Maybe
don't
I wasn't meant
that.
To have children.
Of course you're meant to have children.
But how will I go along with no wife to mother my child?
Look. Tell him the story of how it all happened. Be father and mother, you know what to do. Sometimes people leave you halfway through.
Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom.
Careful the things you say.
Lived a young maiden.
Children will listen.
A sad young lad.
Careful the things you do. Children will see.
And a child is bigger.
And learn.
With
his life. Guide them along.
The wolf was slipping, the giant, the way is dark, the light is dim.
12, into the woods, it's nearing midnight. Into the woods, to mind the wolf, to heed the wish, to honor the giant, to mind, to heed, to find, to think, to teach, to join, to go to the festival. Into the woods.
Wait, who had that question? I saw this yesterday and I noticed that there were a few parts that changed who was playing them. And so for those actors, I was wondering if you could talk about how that process is of like sharing a role with someone and trying to balance that with somebody else.
Well, the hardest part was just like, I think it was just remembering each other's lines, because I had, you know, I was playing Ash, like, you know, Jack has more lines than Lucinda does, so for her to memorize Jack's lines and Lucinda's lines was probably hard, but for me to remember Lucinda's lines and my lines wasn't as difficult, because when you're memorizing lines, you have to remember people's lines before you and after you, that would be all the same. Cool. Yeah.
Probably noticed my like scene was very short. I didn't have much time, so I was just watching everyone. My problem wasn't with memorization, it was more like with singing and blocking. Like I didn't really know where to go or what to do or how to sing, which means I had to join her when she would go to her lunch rehearsals to see how she did it, and then to practice how she did it when I went home. It was a lot for me on the vocal aspect, I guess.
And she did a great job.
Yeah, can y'all summarize the first one?
Avery,
Just to answer your question, the play was about four people who in the the first show last year, if you saw it, all have differences, all have things going on in their lives, and they all want things. After the first play, they got all the ones, but not realizing there was consequences behind what they did. So now the giant is coming down to bring down her wrath upon us because of a boy named Jack, because he stole her. Y'all stop throwing shade.
To add on to what he said, basically, it was just like different fairy tales all combined into one and composed of the baker and the baker's life, like the dogs, the woods. Then they see all these people that's in the story that everyone knows about. They want something, everybody else wants something. And they have to all, like, basically go on a mission to get this, get that. Then Jack, like he said, he goes and he steals from a giant, and he kills a giant. And that's how it tries to get the second one, because his wife comes in and then tries to get the one that goes
out to get. Okay, I'm going to jump to the next question because I don't want to run out of time. And I think that was going to be the
Do any of you guys think you guys can relate to your character? Can you guys relate to your character in any way?
She said, can y'all relate to your character in any way?
Alright, so me being sarcastic, because it was supposed to be sarcastic, but I was like, I'm just serious. Being sarcastic is like,
mostly me.
Dead ass.
Yeah. Sorry, 2 minutes.
Be quiet.
I heard the
Thing.
The pump.
The
pump. Sorry. Excuse me.
When you're on stage, we'll be quiet for you.
I'm